Excessive face and head sweating. Causes and how to stop it. Sweating is a healthy natural process that helps cool the body and prevent overheating. However, some people may experience excessive sweating of the face and head, which could be a sign of an underlying condition. Hyperhidrosis is one such condition for people with hyperhidrosis. Sweating can be excessive. Craniofacial hyperhidrosis occurs when hyperhidrosis affects the face or head. Watch on to learn more about what hyperhidrosis is, why it can impact the head and face, how to stop excessive sweating. What is hyperhidrosis? Hyperhidrosis means too much or hyper sweating or hydrosis. It occurs when someone sweats when they do not need or it does not make sense to. It is fairly common, impacting an estimated 1 to 3 people per 100 people. The purpose of sweat is to cool down the body. In hyperhidrosis, sweating occurs even when there is no need to cool the body. There are two types of hyperhidrosis: primary focal hyperhidrosis and secondary hyperhidrosis. Primary focal hyperhidrosis is the most common type of hyperhidrosis. It occurs when excessive or extreme sweating is not related to another medical condition or medication use. When the cause of hyperhidrosis is medication or a medical condition, it is called secondary hyperhidrosis. Why the head and face? When hyperhidrosis impacts the head, scalp and face, it is called craniofacial hyperhidrosis. It may also affect the palms of the hands, soles of the feet, chest, groin, armpits. There is no precise definition of excessive sweating. That said, people with craniofacial hyperhidrosis tend to experience sweating on the face, head, or scalp that occurs for no apparent reason, such as heat, exercise, or anxiety. Causes dripping or soaking. Smells different than the usual underarm sweat. May impact only one or two body regions while the rest of the body stays cool. Causes someone to be embarrassed and therefore avoid physical contact or being around others. Interferes with everyday activities such as working, exercising, or driving. Causes someone to have to change their clothes or bath more than normal. May reduce self-esteem and cause someone to become overly self-conscious. May interfere with personal relationships. Occurs at least once per week. May be worse first thing in the morning. Hyperhidrosis can impact anyone and occur at any age, but people with primary hyperhidrosis tend to experience symptoms as children or after reaching puberty. Primary hyperhidrosis tends to cause excessive sweating that impacts both sides of the body equally. It also tends to affect one or two body regions while the rest of the body stays cool. Symptoms of primary hyperhidrosis may improve with age. People with secondary hyperhidrosis tend to experience symptoms throughout the entire body, and symptoms can begin at any age. Symptoms also tend to develop suddenly. Secondary hyperhidrosis may also cause excessive night sweats. People with craniofacial hyperhidrosis may be more sensitive to and embarrassed by their symptoms compared to other types of hyperhidrosis because it is hard to hide. The face also plays an important role in and how most people present and express themselves. Causes. Sweating is usually controlled by brain signals sent along sympathetic nerves to sweat glands in the skin. Sympathetic nerves are part of the autonomic nervous system, which controls many body functions, including sweating. When someone's body temperature increases, the brain sends signals to initiate sweating to help release internal heat and cool the body. Sweating may also occur in response to emotions such as embarrassment or anxiety. The cause of primary hyperhidrosis remains unknown. Hyperhidrosis seems to impact the eccrine sweat glands or water-producing sweat glands rather than the apocrine or oil-producing glands. It may occur when the brain sends signals to cool the body when it is not necessary. Genetic factors may play a role in primary hyperhidrosis. About 33% of people with hyperhidrosis have a family member with the same condition. In some instances, there is no apparent cause of secondary hyperhidrosis. However, secondary hyperhidrosis may occur due to infections, diabetes, menopause or after pregnancy, overactive thyroid gland or hyperthyroidism, low blood sugar or hyperglycemia, obesity, gout, tumors, some antidepressant medications, Parkinson's disease, drug or alcohol use or withdrawal from drugs or alcohol, injuries such as head trauma, frostbite, blood cell or bone marrow disorders such as Hodgkin lymphoma, certain rare inherited conditions, irritation or diseases that impact the sympathetic nerves. Diagnosis. To diagnose hyperhidrosis, a doctor will ask someone about their symptoms and examine affected areas. They may also run a sweat test, which involves covering affected areas of the skin with a powder that turns purple when wet. A doctor may then run a series of blood and urine tests and potentially imaging tests to check for other causes of excessive sweating. They will also review the medications and supplements someone is taking to determine whether they may be causing the excessive sweating. If no other cause can be determined, a doctor is likely to diagnose primary hyperhidrosis. If a doctor finds a cause, the diagnosis will be secondary hyperhidrosis. Triggers. A range of factors may trigger symptoms of hyperhidrosis. These factors are typically those that would increase body temperature or the risk of sweating. Common triggers include warm weather, alcohol, spicy foods, anxiety, wearing tight, thick or restrictive clothing, exercise, hot sausage or spicy condiments, curry and cumin, caffeine, monosodium glutamate or MSG. How to stop the sweating? There are a few at-home remedies that may help reduce symptoms of hyperhidrosis or make them more manageable. Common tips include avoiding warm weather or places, wearing loose, thin or lightweight clothes, wearing lighter colors such as white rather than darker clothing that shows sweat easier, using an antiperspirant rather than deodorant, wearing clothes made out of natural fibers instead of synthetic fibers, keeping towels or a cloth made of moisture absorbing or wicking materials close by to dab the face or head. Wearing sweat bands. Carrying a personal fan to cool the face and head. Treating anxiety using stress reducing techniques or cognitive behavioral therapy CBT. Using unscented facial powder. Staying hydrated. Keeping the hair up, away from the face and neck.